Hey everybody, welcome to Chorder Club. On today's video, we're going to be talking all about chording, which is one of the coolest aspects of CharaChorder technology, but also one of the most useful. First, we're going to go into what is a chord. What do we mean when we say the word chord as it relates to a keyboard and working with a computer? Then we're going to talk about what the benefits of chording are. Why do you even care if you can chord with your keyboard, and what does it offer you, and why you might be excited to get an intelligent keyboard that allows you to chord. And then what we're going to do is we're going to give you two examples of these chording-enabled keyboards. In this video, we'll talk about the CharaChorder 1 and the CharaChorder Lite, just to give you a little bit of a taste of what it looks like and which users might want to use the different devices. After that, we're going to close and we'll have a quick conclusion and give you some homework on where to go next. So I'm excited to get started, so why don't we just hop into what is a chord? So I think the easiest way to explain this is with an analogy, which should be pretty familiar with a lot of people, but that is with music. So I want you to imagine in your mind a piano. So a piano has individual keys. You can press individual keys to make individual sounds. I can press an A, an F, whatever it is, right? And I can make that music note sound. Well, on a piano, if you press multiple keys at the same time, you can combine those keys together to make up a different sound. It has a different sound to it, and that's what's important. So in terms of a chording-enabled keyboard, like the CharaChorders or an intelligent keyboard, a chord is basically just a way to press many letters or keys at once and get something different out than what you actually typed. So I want to show this actually on a CharaChorder Lite. It's going to be what most people are pretty familiar with. It looks and feels exactly like a normal keyboard, but it's an intelligent one because it has the chording enabled technology. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share my screen here, and I just want to go ahead and show you an example. So let's see. Should have my screen up here. And I've got my CharaChorder Lite here. You can see it's just got a normal QWERTY layout. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to type the word word, W-O-R-D. And so you can see that that was all letter by letter. And then a chord is basically pressing all of those keys at once. And then you can see that CharaChorder's internal processor rearranges all those letters into the word. Now, that's a little bit of a weird way to say it, because really what's happening is when I press all of these letters, CharaChorder backspaces them all really, really fast and then outputs the right word. And the reason why that's an important distinction is because something we also often get a misconception about is that you have to type all the letters of the word. So in this case, I am pressing all the letters of the word, but I could also do something like this, world, which I'm just pressing W, R, and O, or W, O, R, and it's outputting world. So I hope this makes sense. A chord can basically just be seen as sort of a quick way to type a word. I'll talk a little bit about it in the benefits section on why this is really cool and useful, but I hope this explanation makes sense and you understand what a chord is now. So with that, I think we should go into the benefits. So now that we know how to chord and really just how easy it is to chord, I think this is a great segue into our next topic, which is really just what are the benefits of chording and why might it be interesting to you? So the first topic is to talk about basically just the amount of effort. So we saw in the example that I showed that instead of having to type every letter by letter the word word, I could type in one keystroke the entire word at once. And so that kind of leads into what I'm talking about here, which is just that for the word that you want to type, by chording, it takes less physical and mental effort to actually type it. So I think this is really best illustrated when I show you on my screen with my hands shown on my keyboard. So you can kind of see what is actually physically happening. So I've got Notepad open and I just want to show you an example. So great word example. So I typed the word example, and you notice that it took me, what is that, 7 keystrokes to type? So that's typing letter by letter, and my brain has to process that. I have to think, how do I spell the word example? It's E-X-A-M-P-L-E, okay? With chording, it is just so much easier because what happens is you build up this muscle memory. So I know the chord, for example, is just moving my hand like this. So example, 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 right? And just look at the amount of effort, like, that's it. That's the only effort. And one keystroke, one quick fluid movement, I can output an entire word, as opposed to having to type all the letters, and you can see I'm doing all kind of typos. Yeah, so that's one of the benefits. And that also leads into speed. So the speed at which you can output a chord is just unmatched by normal typing. Even some of the fastest typists in the world, can't match the speed that you can output with a chord. And you'll notice I messed up there, but CharaChorder is intelligent and it lets me just fix it really quickly. So it's really flexible in that way. Now you might be thinking, well, I need a chord for every word. That's just not quite true. One of the benefits of using a chording-enabled device that is intelligent is that you can mix it. I have an example. You can mix character entry with chorded entry, and in doing so, you can kind of slowly introduce yourself into chording. So it's really flexible in that way, and there's just immediate gains to be had in terms of both speed and, as I was mentioning, productivity. And finally, the last benefit that I really want to talk about is just something that we tend to call fluency. And it's just this concept of being able to think in words and output those words in one swift motion without having to think letter by letter. So what I mean is, to me, when I'm typing letter by letter, I'm thinking about each individual letter and I'm composing a sentence, I have to think about each letter as I type it, sort of. And that slows you down. There's a certain mental load that it takes to do that. But when you have a chord and once you've mastered it, it's sort of just second nature. When you think the word example, you just type it. You think important, you think without, you just get the entire word. So it's really hard to explain, but hopefully as we work on this course together, you'll start to feel this as you learn to chord eventually. But this concept, this idea of fluency with the computer is really what we're about at CharaChorder. So, you know, our mission, type at the speed of thought, that's really what we're trying to describe there, is that just that ability to output entire words the moment you think them. There's just nothing like it. And I really don't know how to explain it, but I hope you understand what I'm trying to say here. So anyway, so I think that's a pretty good summary of the benefits. And where we want to go next is to basically just introduce two of the chording-enabled keyboards that you can get your hands on today. And hopefully by the end of that section, you'll be able to choose which one you really like and you want to continue on further into the course. All right, so let's take a look. Let's look at the two devices we're going to talk about today, which are the CharaChorder Lite and the CharaChorder One. So let me share what I've got for you here. So here is the CharaChorder Lite. Hopefully this isn't too close of a view, but it is a mechanical keyboard. Much like you'd be used to if you have tried any sort of gaming keyboards. It's got a very tactile switch in it. Feels really nice. Not a lot of force, which is great for the chording. And this is going to be a really good device for someone who really just wants to get into chording and doesn't want to have a long learning curve if they already know how to type on a QWERTY or other layout because you can remap it. But the cool thing about this is these switches and keycaps are all customizable. It's a mechanical hot swappable keyboard, so you can switch those out for whatever you would like if you're into that kind of thing. Now, if you want a bit of a challenge, and let me just move this out of the way. So to be clear, you can start using the CharaChorder Lite and immediately start to get benefits. I think when I started using my CharaChorder Lite, within the first day, I'd already broken some of my previous typing records, and within the first month, I was blowing them out of the water. Now, if you want a little bit more of a challenge, which, you know, if you're like me, is definitely where you're at, you're gonna wanna get the CharaChorder 1. So the CharaChorder 1 is not a traditional keyboard by any means. It has all of these switches that you rest your hand on here, and you can wiggle them in different directions, north, south, west, and east, and then also 3D press them down into the CharaChorder 1 itself. And each of those can be an output. This one, you know, your hands are always resting on the device, so you never have to sort of refine yourself. I notice just in this video, when I look at some of the recordings of me typing to my light, I often have to look down to reorganize and reset myself on where I am on the keyboard. Whereas with this, you'll never see me looking down at the CharaChorder 1 because, you know, I can just immediately know where I am. So this one definitely takes a little bit of getting used to. Most people can pass, at least on a one-time sort of short test, the average QWERTY speed of 40 words per minute in the first month, but it varies a lot. Some people are much faster than that. Some people are much slower than that. It really just depends on your learning style and how long it's gonna take you to pick up. We definitely recommend practicing 15, 20 minutes a day, and you'll be learning the layout pretty quickly. But we're gonna be going over all of that in these videos. So again, if you're up for a challenge and you want the sort of maximum potential, this is definitely the device for you. It has all the ergonomics potentials with this removable bar here, which is actually how I usually use mine. I put it on for this video. I usually have this off and then have them spread out apart for some nice ergonomics. The layout itself for the CharaChorder 1 is based on the English language. It was basically studied and then designed for the most common bigrams and trigrams, which we'll talk more about later in the course, to be easily typed and, you know, to make better use of your thumbs, as well as left versus right alternations between the two hands. So basically, long story short, it's a super powered layout and a super powered form function, and it's going to give you the most long-term potential typing speed and other ergonomics compared to the Lite. But again, the Lite is great because you can just jump right in and immediately get benefits. So I hope that's a pretty good summary for you to see the two devices. We're gonna be going into each of these devices after this, and we're gonna be taking a look at each one and what comes in the box and how you get started using it. So with that, I think we're gonna go ahead and close. I'll give you a quick recap, and then I'm gonna give you the homework for the video. So why don't we go into that? All right, that was a lot of fun. Hopefully you learned a little bit in this video. I hope you learned what is a chord and just how easy it is to actually execute it. All you have to do is press all the letters in the chord and then release all the letters in the chord, and out comes a word or a series of words or whatever you choose. Then we talked about the benefits of chording and how it can increase your productivity and your speed, and it reduces the effort for you to type significantly. And then finally, we talked about two of the CharaChorder devices that allow you to chord today, and that is the CharaChorder Lite and the CharaChorder 1. Remember, if you want a little bit of an easier learning curve, the CharaChorder Lite is the way to go for you. But if you're really up for that challenge, then the CharaChorder 1 is definitely for you, and you're gonna love it 100%. Which brings us to the best part of the video, your homework. Just kidding. You do have some homework though. If you would like to go on this chording journey with us, let me know down in the comments which device you chose, and then I'll see you in the next video. We're gonna be splitting off at this point into a CharaChorder 1 specific playlist and a CharaChorder Lite specific playlist. So I hope to see you in one or maybe both. Thanks.